before the history begins, this is really important. I am considering starting a new series that is Kakeyama Tobio X New Manager Listener, if I'm correct. I found that fanfiction for not too long ago, and I was wondering if you guys want to see that. Comment down below if you want to see that. But no further ado, I'll continue with the video. Kakeyama Tobio X Reader. Name Clingy. Written by Amy 1234U. On Wattpad. Link in the description below. Yes, your boyfriend was the genius editor. Yes, he was the king of the court. Yes, he's such an idiotic partner that can hit amazing spikes with a super duper fast set. You sighed and genuinely stared at Kageyama's back. He was busy looking down at his work. You already finished since. Hello? You're like at the top three in your class. Kageyama felt your stare, but didn't bear to turn around. Kageyama wasn't big on affection as you were. You weren't the one asking him, though. He sighed the chance before he went to Karasuno, asking you that summer. You're his neighbor, a pretty neighbor, in fact. Kageyama's mother was best friend with yours, and it became history. You heard the last bell and rushed to his side. Are you going to practice today? You asked. Of course, what do you think, idiot? Kageyama answered. You pouted. Well, good luck. I had to go home due to some kind of emergency babysitting, you know. So you had to walk me home today. Bye bye, he said. He rushed outside the classroom, catching up with some of your classmates as they headed the same way. Kageyama watched your retreating figure. He frowned. Whatever, like a care. Hey King, where's your girlfriend? Tsukishima asked playfully. Kageyama glared. She went home early, babysitting. He grumbled. Hinata, who just got in the gym, poked Kageyama. But I saw her go home with male name from her class. She was laughing and they seemed close. Kageyama took a double take at Hinata. That's not true. Was it? Besides, you're like his number one fan and you wouldn't cheat on him on a bit. After practice ended, Kageyama decided to stop at Yukai's store a bit to buy some snacks. He went in to see you. And exactly what Hinata said, you were with another boy. His arms were around you. You're affectionate all to him. When? Kageyama asked. You turned and smiled. You all seemed to glow now. Tobio! He squealed. You laughed. You launched yourself onto him, peppering him with chin kisses, since you couldn't reach his lips. When no kissing, he stammered. You led him outside with the guest. Who are you? He asked coldly. Male's name. Wayne's childhood friend. I get to visit since I moved to Kyoto a while ago. Male's name explained. Yeah, I was so excited when he came home. He piped. Wait, you said you were babysitting. Kageyama pointed confusedly. You laughed. I was babysitting him. He answered. You hugged his arm. Come on, let's grab some dinner at my place. Kageyama grumbled as he saw how male name was always over you. Do you need help with the rice? Male name asked. Nope, I'm good. Go mingle, he said. You turned back into the kitchen and busied yourself with the meal. Meal's name glared over at Kageyama. He glared back. Jeez, no need to glare, Meal name said. It's natural, Kageyama snapped. How long are you two being together? Meal name asked. A couple of months, he answered. Kageyama sighed. Meal name smirked. Not so long, huh? You didn't seem the kind of, like, clingy girls like Wayan. He whispered. Kageyama blanked out. Was Wayan that clingy? Okay, sort of. But, like, it's not that bad, is it? Kageyama snapped out of his thoughts. When you handed him a rice ball. Time to eat. He teared. As the boys make their way through the food, you paid close attention to how tense they were. You weren't an airhead. You knew what was going on. Mainlem asked you out in the first year of middle school, before you moved. You sighed, nah, I can't reach the rice cooker. Can you spoon more rice? He asked. Kageyama male's name. Edamon reached at the same time. They looked at each other before Kageyama took it away. Mine. He grumbled. He spooned you your portion and handed it back. Thank you. He couldn't kiss his cheek. He blushed but remained still, knowing that male name would probably think he had a phobia for clingy girls. Kageyama cleared his throat and picked up some piece of meat. He put it to his lips. He mumbled. Now it was your turn to blush. You opened your mouth and welcomed the sour meat. Male named aside. Guess I really can't say have her. The next morning, Kageyama was tackled by you. Oi, what was that for? He shouted. You shut up by pressing her lips close to his. He smiled. Who said I was clingy? He teased playfully. Though, Menkating Aura said otherwise. And so, Kageyama never thought of you as clingy again. Or as insane. That was the fanfiction. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next video. Bye!